Hey, what is going on, guys, and welcome to Tomb Raider. This is going to be the next walkthrough that I'm doing, and I'm extremely excited. If you guys are, like, if you like my Facebook page or if you follow me on Twitter, you guys knew I was doing this about 3 weeks ago, but let's hop into the game here. I've already downloaded the downloadable content, which I can't access until a certain point in the game, which is cool, but we're going to go ahead and start a new game. But before I do that, I want to make sure that the subtitles and everything are straight, which I think they should be. And yep, subtitles are actually no. Okay, they're on. So we'll go ahead and leave that alone. And gameplay, I don't know, sensitivity. We'll adjust things once we get into the game, and I'll try to judge it once I get in the game. But let's go ahead and get this started. And this is gonna be Tomb Raider, and this is the new story for Lara. Or I keep hearing Laura and Lara, and then Lara, and I need to distinguish which one it is, but we'll see what happens, guys. Let's get this started.
A famous explorer once said that the extraordinary is in what we do, not who we are. I'd finally set out to make my mark, to find adventure, but instead, adventure found me. In our darkest moments, when life flashes before us, we find something. Something that keeps us going. Something that pushes us.
Okay, so the official, I have to say this now, the official craziest intro to a game goes to Tomb Raider. I don't think I've seen an intro this crazy before. Your ship, pretty, I don't even know what happened to the ship, but it split in half apparently, and then you get whacked in the head from behind by some guy on a beach, and then apparently they couldn't hear me yelling, and I guess there was a, like, thunderstorm or a tsunami outside, I don't know, it was weird, but this is not looking good. I see a bunch of skulls everywhere, which means a lot of people have obviously died, because that is quite the collection of skulls. And this game actually looks pretty good. Crystal Dynamics, great jobs with development. And this is not good. We are apparently hanging upside down, or we're in space, and I'm pretty sure it's upside down, because space doesn't make any sense. Okay. Okay, I can move now. Okay, cool. So, I'm swinging, which I guess, yeah, let's see what we're supposed to do. Oh, never mind. Okay, am I doing it right? Swing again. Don't turn your head towards it, Laura. You're going to hurt yourself. Oh, that's, okay. That's not good. I don't know if I can. Okay, it's not letting me go. Okay, now I have to go left or right again. Okay, so let's try this. This is gonna suck. I'm already knowing because the skeleton got wrecked and I got close that time. Didn't actually hit it. There we go. Okay, that's not good. Get out of there before you light on fire. Oh no. Move. That's gotta hurt. Is that a bone or a nail? I can't. Okay, let's get that thing out of here. Oh, that sucks, man. Okay, so it's not just human heads in here. It looks like there are horses' heads right in front of me. If the screen will stop blurring, which is the nicest thing about this game, I think, from what I've seen so far, is how the game kind of, the camera kind of twists and pans in and out when you move in and out of objects, and then all the, it's just a really interesting game. It's very cinematic, which is what I keep hearing from people. Okay, that's not cool. What is that? She is obviously dead. There's a bunch of flies flying around, and there's a, I mean, where do they get all these people to kill? All these skulls, are you serious? I mean, it's not like there's an art supply store to buy skulls from. I mean, this is ridiculous. And Laura, this player model looks really good, but this is there anything over here? I don't think, no, I think we're just gonna keep walking this way. But that is, I believe, I think that's a chick. What's that on the background? Is that, I don't know. It looks like another. Oh, cool. So his first thing I can interact with is a torch, and I guess we're gonna keep going this way. Oh, okay, so we're gonna light this up, hold X, and apparently all the wood on this island is very combustible, which is kind of weird because you would expect, I don't know, so I'm not gonna, it's a video game, guys, I'm not gonna go into detail. I barely touched those cans. Are you serious? No, I wasn't talking about Laura's cans. I was talking about I was talking about cans in general. All right. So survival instinct. And it, I guess it just shows us stuff to light up, or it shows us how to get out of an area. So, oh, how is this? Okay, so it's not deactivated by left bumper. So what do I do? Is it just? Oh, so oh, I got it. Okay. So I just move, and that's, it's pretty similar to the detective mode for Batman, I guess. I don't know when I'm gonna start seeing enemies, but I guess I can use it in the same way. But for right now, it's kind of telling me what to light, what to blow up, and I kind of don't want to be anywhere near that oil drum because that's gonna blow up, and I want to get back in this corner. Okay, and that crate clearly hit me and I took no damage from it. I don't know what's going on here, but let's climb this. Okay, that's, I don't, do I need to go in here? Because that's gonna fall. Let me get through here real fast. Oh, no. Let go of me. Let go. Get away from me. There are perverts on this island. That's what perverts say. I'm trying to help you. you know what? I don't know if any of you guys are too old for this, but if you remember that Scooby-Doo episode, this, I'm going like, back in the 90s here, but that Scooby-Doo episode where, or maybe the 80s, I'm not 100% sure, but I remember watching in the 90s when I was a kid, but that one with the old prospector and the mountain, or that, the hermit, there we go, he was a hermit, and the Scooby-Doo and the gang just left, and they drove off, and he was yelling, come back, and that kind of reminds me of that guy. Sorry for the trip back in time, I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys don't know what I'm talking about, but we'll go ahead and pretend that you do. And we're gonna have to walk through this again. What are you complaining about? You just walked through another waterfall.
Need to find a way out.
All right, so I guess based on where, yeah, I'm pretty sure the oil drums pretty much mean explosion, which means that, yep, that's what I thought. That's your way out. So you gotta use that to get out. Can we go up this way? Nope, not that way. So we're going back through here. Alright, so let's use this. And I'm not 100% sure what we're doing, but...
What kind of contraption is this?
Oh, never mind. These just lit up for me. So I guess we're gonna go ahead and light these bad boys on fire. And all these are support ties. So we'll go ahead and light these up too. Alright, cool. So... let's see what's next. Oh, okay. So we can light these on fire. Which I guess is cool. And we'll light this. And... oh, those aren't... okay, those won't explode. I thought those were gonna explode, but... I think we're fine. Let's head up this way. Oh, crap. Okay, so stuff is just falling apart everywhere. All this stuff is made of, like... 2x4s, and I'm surprised this is holding it together. But I think we're gonna jump here. And Laura can jump. That's pretty sweet. And apparently she weighs enough to lift all those crates and combustible objects. And that's, I guess that's cool. I don't know. Let's hop down. And I don't know. Does she have a sprint button that I can use? I'm not 100. All those things that I've seen, I haven't really seen anything for sprint. Let's go ahead and push this. And those should light on fire. Yep. Put a hole in that wall. Alright, so let's get out of here. 250 XP coming my way. And, okay, this is falling apart. Let me not be in here. Come on, Laura. You gotta have a sprint button. Okay, not that way. Okay, so we're running towards the light. Which, oh. No, that's, okay. Okay. I'm surprised she's holding up as well as she is. I mean, she's not really wearing any clothes, which is, like, kind of dangerous, but... nice. Okay, she made that one. The timing these jumps with the camera shaking like this is really weird, but it does add a nice effect to the game, and I guess we gotta go through here. Oh, no, this guy again? Get away from me. Yeah, in the face. Oh, his head exploded. Oh my, oh, that's no good. No good. Get out of here. Yes, I made it. No. Get it. Lord, oh, you. There we go, yeah. Okay, left, I was pressing the thumbsticks again. Left and right trigger, let's get out of here. Woo! Woo! Oh man, this is crazy. Nice, nice. Okay, I saw that one coming. I have a feeling like I'm gonna die a lot of the times in this game. You guys know I suck with quick time events if you've seen Far Cry 3. This is gonna be a really long game. This is gonna be a long game. But I'm excited. And we escaped the perverts and the hermit. And we're covered in blood. And I'm pretty sure it's all Varus. This is a nice looking island. There's a lot of crap on this. We're obviously not the only people to crash here. I mean, there's boats, there's a plane, there's another boat, there's another, look at all these boats. We are not the only people to crash here. There's pirate ships. I mean, Tomb Raider, obviously. But I mean, there's like 5-6 boats that I've seen. I'm pretty sure we're gonna see more. And I guess we're going this way. There's a lifeboat down there. I guess we're gonna go check that out. Art gallery unlocked. Main menu. So I guess we're gonna be unlocking art throughout the game.
A lifeboat. Where are they? They must have gone inland.
Oh, you got. I love British accents. I do. And this is gonna drive me crazy. So I'm gonna have my moments in here, guys. And I don't know if this is safe because. Everything else is falling apart. Why should I trust this? I mean, this is... okay. I'm not sure. Is this going to be like... okay. Let's do this. No. Straighten up. Straighten up. I don't want to die 15 minutes into the... Oh. Okay. Let's do this. Come on. No. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Come on. You're almost there. There we go. Woo! Oh, wow. Thought I was going to die 15 minutes into the game. That was not going to be good. Let's keep moving this way. So the lifeboat was somewhere. Okay, so it's not here. Let's keep moving. Okay, I guess we're still going this way. It's a pretty straight path. Yep, there is. How did that plane get there? This is probably not gonna work out. Okay. So do I press A to get up there? Or okay, there we go. Woo! Okay, so now I have to use more buttons. Are you serious? So now I have to use X to grab on this stuff. This is gonna be a long game. Come on, there. Okay, there we go. So there's a little bit of recovery time. I'm not sure if that has anything to do with the difficulty. Oh, get out the way, Laura. Get out the way. I refuse to die in the first episode. I'm on a mission to not die in the first episode. Because that is going to clearly not be a good idea. Lifeboat's down there, so I guess we're almost there. Wall scramble. Press A mid-jump. Okay. Nice. Okay, so it's a lot of different things I'm going to have to learn and learn how to time. And okay, so that was a pretty hard fall. I wish I could have slid down, but hey, it's all good. And the rain is washing all that blood off from earlier. Yay.
They must have come this way.
So there's a camcorder and some matches and a radio.
Can anyone hear me?
And obviously the radio wouldn't work. Let's see. Let's say it's a two-way radio, so it's just between me and someone else. Hopefully it's not another pervert. And I don't think there's anything over here for me to grab. So we'll keep heading on our merry way. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, okay. No, okay, I was pressing X to climb. Was that scripted? Or okay, I guess it was. I'm not sure. Because we still, our objective is still going. Take shelter from the storm. And I'm going to try not... Oh, crap. Is that a wolf? Okay, so I'm going to try not to use the little nature thing as much as possible. Or the objective finder thing. The little... I don't know. I think it's going to be a little cheap. But I think I should be good. And we are obviously cold. And we're obviously in a great deal of pain.
Looks abandoned.
Alright, so we need to go obviously find some fire.
Is anyone listening? Please respond.
Oh man, she's cold. You can tell. I mean, it's what you get for wearing a type of clothing. Well, she was about to go to sleep anyway when the ship broke down, so I guess she's fine. Are we gonna get to make a fire? Oh, it's only one match. Oh, that's gonna suck. Don't give me control over this, because I'm gonna mess it up. Don't. Oh, nice. I'm glad this is a cutscene, because if this was a quick time event, I would have messed this up already. And we have fire. I don't think Laura watched the Hunger Games, because if you lit that fire, people knew where to find you, and that's how you die. So lighting that big, I guess I don't know, it's a video game, it's not. Camcorder time?
Here's the soon-to-be world-famous archaeologist, Lara Croft, in her native habitat. She's on the hunt for the lost kingdom of Yamatai, home to the fabulous Himiko, mythical sun queen, and ancestor of yours truly.
Sam, this is serious.
Oh, sweetie, I know. I'm just trying to lighten the mood here. Everyone's so on edge. What are you so worried about?
I'm close to something. I'm sure of it. I just don't know if the others will listen. Or even if they should.
Lara, you know this stuff better than anyone. Seriously, I'm not just saying this to make you feel better. I trust you. Roth trusts you. You got this. Now let's take a break, okay?
Okay, okay. And Sam, thanks.
She's not always this serious, you know?
How can you suggest I'm not serious about this expedition? Lara, it's not just Sam's family funding us. I put my savings on the line, too.
We've all got some kind of stake in this. The funding won't last forever, Whitman.
That's precisely why we should push east, not west.
No one believes Yamatai is that far east. The books simply don't support it.
Well, whoever wrote those books never found Yamatai.
I've talked to Roth about this. There's no point in following in other people's footsteps, Dr. Whitman.
I refuse to bet my reputation on your hunch. I'm the lead archaeologist here.
And when were you last in the field without a TV crew behind you?
Got 30 years experience, 2 PhDs, 1 in East Asian history. So why don't you just stick to boats, Mr. Grimm?
Ship, Dr. Whitman. It's a ship. Don't need a PhD to know that.
Going east will take us directly into the Dragon's Triangle. That's where we need to go.
Lara, my little bird. I'd follow you almost anywhere, but that place has a bad energy.
Bad storms, more like, makes the Bermuda Triangle look like Disney World. Sign me up.
The stories about Queen Himiko say she could summon storms. Myths are usually based on some version of the truth. What if Yamatai was somewhere in the Triangle itself?
Well, look, this is the satellite imagery from inside the Dragon's Triangle.
That doesn't look good.
If it's wet, I can sail on it.
Oh, don't tell me you're seriously
Reyes is right. We don't have the funds to piss about. It's now or never. Lara's offering fresh ideas and a plan. I'm the captain here. It's my decision. We're going into the Dragon's Triangle.
Why am I even here? Alright, so woman versus wild. Search for food. Let's go find some food. I guess our wound has healed. Oh crap, that's not gonna get me any food.
Oh god. What's going on here?
Man, everybody is hanging upside down and dead. I don't get this. This island is ridiculous. Okay, so I think... Oh, there's some arrows here I guess I can pick up. So that's 3 arrows. And then I guess we're going this way. And that's some more arrows. So that's 8 total. And we'll go ahead and vault this. Alright, so let's try to do this. Yeah, got it. There you go. Oh, come on. This. Well, was that a bullet wound in his head? Makeshift longbow, new gear acquired.
Just remember Roth's training.
You can have the best form and technique in the world.
Hold left trigger to aim. Right trigger is to shoot.
Key to using any weapon.
I think this guy had a bullet wound in his head. Well, I can't see it now, but I gotta go watch that again.
I need to find something to eat.
See if I can get a little advantage over my prey. See if I can find someone to shoot with this bow and arrow. Okay, good to know she didn't die from that. There's one deer over there. Oh, nice. Nice. Far Cry 3 has put my bow skills to another level. You cannot run from me. I'm a beast. This is done. It's a done deal.
Sorry.
Oh, this is gonna suck. Ah. Well, at least I don't have to see this, because this... I mean, there's blood splatter on the screen, but I think I'm... Alright, so we got one skill point, and apparently... Okay, so I am gonna...
You won't always have some fancy gadget to tell you where you are. If you can learn to read the land and the stars, you'll always be able to find your way home.
Okay. Going this way. And we're going back this way. Okay, so I'm good from here. I don't need to use it anymore. Okay, so we're at base camp. Spend skill points in the skills menu to upgrade abilities. Let's see what we have. Keen observation allows you to spot hard to find animals. Survivalists earn extra rewards when looting animal corpses and food caches. Nah. Advanced salvaging. Thoroughly search crates and caches to find extra salvage. It's not really important right now. Arrow retrieval. Okay, cool. So this is what I'm gonna go for, because there's multiple. Oh, this is nice. Okay, so ammo capacity. And just because we're not really dealing with that right now, and I kind of don't know how frequently I'm going to find arrows, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to unlock this one. And that's a done deal. So we got that. And let's head back. And we are pretty much... This is where I'm going to end this first episode, guys. We will pick this up immediately from where we left off, and hopefully you guys enjoyed this first episode. I know it was a little wild, but hopefully this game is gonna settle down, because I was a little freaked out at the beginning, but I'll calm down eventually as the game progresses. And I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.